Single air gap magnetic device is shown here. Looking at the flux linkages versus the current characteristics of the device, it exhibits this saturation effect as we discussed before. And that essentially limits the inductor use in a switching converters to have some small average DC current shown here in the dotted lines, and superimposed on that is typical triangular ripple current in inductors in the switching converters. Of course, the peak of this current is limited to this value, at which point the inductance starts saturating, and at that point we'll have this sharp peak of the current, and that in most cases is not acceptable in switching converters. However, if we now increase the air gap, the net effect will be that we will be reducing the inductance, which is the slope of this characteristics, effectively means that by increasing the gap, we are reducing inductance, and therefore, at this point, we can now, if we still further increase the inductance.
Okay, I think one thing, this is a great view graph that I made, which shows the effect. A long time ago, when I talked about air gap in magnetic circuits, I used this view graph where I physically moved around this, opening up the gap, makes a bigger the gap, a smaller inductance. Of course, this is misleading in a sense that you don't need this huge gap to reduce only three times the slope. If you have a ferrite core, which has 2,000 typically, sometimes even 10,000 depending on type of a core, let's say 2,000 relative permeability, and that means slope is of this inductance is 2,000 times higher than the what would be if the core saturates and you have it in a free space. It turns out that it takes a very little air gap to very little air gap to kill inductance from 2,000 times down to two or three times. I remember, I'll give you one example. A long time ago, and how I realized that that's a problem of power electronics. I had my true converter with triple output and made it for a original Lisa computer at the time, which used a 150-watt flyback converter, and I replaced it with my true converter and with the triple output and single magnetics. But the main point was that the gap we had to use at 20 kilohertz, because at 20 kilohertz, we had to use a gap which was 1 millimeter. 1 millimeter gap. Remember, this is not a gap, a real gap at that time for 5 volt, 30 amp output at 20 kilohertz, real gap was 1 millimeter. And 1 millimeter gap, you know what it did for the inductance of the core? Reduced the inductance by a factor of 100. So instead of 2,000, it was not actually, it was more. It reduced it down to 2,000, down to a factor of 2.5. Let's say 2. So basically, all the core did, all the magnetic core did is used to define the 1 millimeter gap. And it was useless because it was just there to define the 1 millimeter gap and to kill inductance by a factor from 2,000 down to 2. So it only increased, inductance over what it would be if it didn't have a magnetic core, just the same cross-section, same number of turns, but it was done on toroid with no magnetic material. It'll increase inductance by a factor of 2. Isn't that stupid? Isn't that waste? Yes, it is. And what happened, even the company, which was at that time doing in a Silicon Valley for us, they made a 200 prototypes using my converter, and we found out that the core was overheating and shutting off the circuit, and we found what is the problem. You know what? This guy didn't know. We did specify that use 1 millimeter gap, and they didn't specify a magnetic core, pot core at the time, with a built-in air gap. So use the ungapped core. An ungapped core killed ungapped core only provided it was saturated and caused the heating due to core losses, but it has an inductance, which is a air core inductance. What's left is air core inductance. So what is the effect on my circuit? It worked. It worked, except because it has a two times higher, a smaller inductance that would have otherwise with this core not saturating, it was creating the two times higher ripple current and ripple voltage. So my output, instead of having 50 millivolts at 5 volts, you get 100 millivolts. But it exposed this nonsense of air gap in the magnetic circuits, which other people claimed ever since that time, magic of B versus H, and H field now allows all the storage of the energy and so on. You don't want to have a storage, okay? And that is what I want to show you with this demonstration. This is a demonstration which you have to remember. This is 1 millimeter gap is disaster. It will have this inductance from 2,000 permeability down to 2, which is 1,000 times reduced. And what is the point? And the whole field, and you know, now you can, I can explain also why it went in the wrong direction. Because now, if the old days when we were switching at 20 kilohertz, like I did at the time for this Apple design, if you switched at the 20 kilohertz, if it switched at the 5 volt 30 amps, if I needed 100 amps, I needed to have three times, higher gap, which could be even totally just lossless, right? You will lose inductance more. So what if they needed more current, they simply say, oh, don't worry, we'll just go from 20 kilohertz to go to 200 kilohertz. So they were making up loss of inductance, and they're working with basically air core inductances, which saturate, create core losses, and are making a big size, and not making any reduction except driving the frequency to 200 kilohertz in the MOSFET. And that nonsense continue now, driving it to 2 megahertz and 20 megahertz. You see what I'm saying? Because they don't know anything about magnetics, and they don't understand what I've been preaching and explaining them in all of my presentation papers, etc. Okay, so let me show the why this is dramatic reduction of inductance with the demonstration.
Increase the gap and reduce inductance, we can pass much larger current, and at some value shown here, we can pass very large DC current and still not saturate the core. Therefore, the air gap has a positive effect of controlling the DC saturation in a switching converter. The experiment that we'll be showing now here has the single 2213 pot core, which has a screw in a middle, and we can essentially turn around the top part of the core and therefore introduce effectively the air gap in magnetic circuit. We can see on the flux versus leakages versus current characteristics on this trace how by increasing the air gap, the effectively the slope of the characteristics tilts over, and we can pass larger DC current without actually saturating the core. And we see that effect clearly here. We can now observe the same effect on the time domain waveforms on the scope here, and notice again that if we have a very small air gap, the current drawn is relatively small, but by increasing the air gap, the current drawn becomes larger and larger because of reduced inductance, and eventually start seeing the saturation effect by approaching the knee of the BH loop characteristic. I think if we see also back on the scope, we will see on a BH loop characteristic that the effect of the air gap has a tendency to linearize the characteristics of the magnetic material, such that if we started with a small air gap and had the rather large nonlinear shaped characteristics, by increasing and introducing the air gap starts dominating the magnetic device properties and therefore linearizes the magnetic device.
There's one other problem. You see from this waveform here, the flux is still unchanged, but as you go and kill inductance by introducing bigger and bigger gap, what is happening with this current? Current is very small ripple. Now it has a very high ripple current. So RMS current conduction losses become high, and also the core losses that you have in the core, which you shouldn't have it because it doesn't do anything. The whole core does is this define 1 millimeter, or actually better, very small gap behind that. So you can see how useless that whole field. You know, they may talk now of making a 100 kilowatts charger for electric cars, or a 500 kilowatt and a fast charger and so on. They're stuck with this inductance. They can't do it, you know, because the size of, and the other thing which it shows, not only that this gap is small, once you have this gap, which generates just like an air core inductor, maybe two times more, what happens, the only way you can increase the inductance or reduce the ripple is by proportionally increase the cross-section. So do you want to now increase the cross-section to have more inductance? Of course not, because then you're increasing the volume of a core material, you increase the size and weight and cost, and you're not doing anything to help anything, right? You know, that apparently there is bad news is that you may have even ideal transformer, which you don't have, of a Faraday, a Tesla type, but you have basic limitation that all these converters have inductance on the input of the, like a boost, or inductance of the output or back, and worst of them all, flyback, which is actually all storage and no transfer, okay?